channel. And before we get into it, I just gotta say something. A lot of you guys have been checking out my videos are not subscribed. So before you guys continue on with this video, make sure you guys go down below and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And without further ado, let's get it. So, in my last video, I talked about the curious case of Colin Sexton, whether he's a bad player, whether he's a good player, what kind of player is he? And I decided to continue that kind of video to today with a player that a lot of people seem to like and plays for the Chicago Bulls. His name is Zach LaVine. In this video, we're going to be talking about how good actually is Zach LaVine. And before we continue any further, if there's any other player you guys want me to dive into, go ahead and let me know in the comment section down below. I'll be sure to look at it and get into a video about them. So right off the bat, like everybody already knows this, but Zach LaVine is one of the most athletic players in the entire NBA, which you guys can obviously see from all his slam dunk competitions. And Zach LaVine mentioned this lately, but he wants to be known as more than just a dunker. And this season, and not just this season, but really his whole career, he's been much more than just a dunker. So first we're going to start with the good with Zach, that does a really good job of showing that he's not just a dunker, but just a really good scorer in general. So, on the season, Zach LaVine is averaging 25.5 points per game, 4.8 rebounds, 4.2 assists, on 38.0 three-point percentage with 8.1 attempts per game, and a true shooting percentage of 56.8. So right off the bat, you can already tell, Zach is a really good scorer. He's a real efficient scorer too. Anytime you shoot 38% from downtown on 8 attempts per game, you're a really good shooter. And the fact that he has such a high usage as he has, a usage rate of 31.7%, and still puts up rather pretty good efficiency with it too, on such a bad team where he's asked to do so much, that's pretty good, actually really good. Along with this, his offensive box plus minus is 3.3, which is a box score estimate of offensive points per 100 possessions a player provides to his team above a league average player. Zach is ranked 24th in the NBA in that statistic. The Bulls' offense is also 5.7 points better with him on the floor. What these stats are telling you is that Zach is not only just good on offense, he's one of the best offensive players in the entire league when it comes to creating for himself and scoring the ball. He's one of the best and one of the most efficient players in the league when you consider like top 25, top 30. So yeah, when it comes to scoring and self-creation, Zach LaVine is legit one of the best in the league. But similar to what I said in my Colin Sexton video, Zach LaVine struggles to not only play defense, but try on defense, and he's also a pretty awful passer. LaVine averages 4.2 assists, but also averages 3.4 turnovers. That's almost a turnover per assist. For someone with as high as usage rate as LaVine does, you simply can't be that poor of a passer and decision maker. This is the tricky thing with it though. Even with his poor passing, his offensive impact numbers still say he's one of the most impactful players in the league on that end. So imagine if he could just simply get better at passing, how much better of an offensive player he could be in this league. Still, even with the numbers saying how impactful he is on offense, the Bulls are still 4.2 points worse with him on the floor. And like I mentioned in my Colin Sexton video, you know exactly what that means. If the offense is 5.7 points better with you on the floor, and yet you're still a minus 4.2 when you're on the floor, imagine how porous on defense you have to be. Of anyone on the Chicago Bulls roster who's played at least 1,200 minutes, Zach LaVine has the worst defensive rating with a 111.2 rating, 2.3 points worse than second place. And what is by far the most telling and worst stat of it all, the Chicago Bulls team defense is 10 points worse with him on the floor. Like seriously, Zach LaVine is awful on defense, but he may be the most curious case in the NBA right now among bigger name players, because even with his defense being so horrific, and even with his passing being so porous, his box plus minus, which is a box score estimate per 100 possessions a player contributes above a league average player, that was a lot to get out without messing up, is 2.5, and his VORP, with his value over replacement player, a lot more easier to say, is 2.4. His VORP ranking 25th in the entire NBA, and his box plus minus 34th in the entire NBA. Now you think for someone who's only really good at self-creation and scoring and really bad at passing and defense, you think they would be way lower because they can only impact the game in one way. But this just says that Zach is so good at the things he's good at, scoring, shooting, creation off the dribble, that it can still impact the game in a positive way. However, the Bulls are 22-43, and they are 4.2 points worse than him on the floor, and like I said earlier, their defense to 10 points better with him off the court. So what does all this mean? Is Zach LaVine a plus player on the basketball court? Is he someone that you want to be your number one, like the Bulls are building around him? What does all of this mean? This is my conclusion on it. Too many people on Twitter and too many people like to go too much extreme to this way and too much extreme to this way. Either you're saying he's a bad player or you're saying he's a fantastic player. I think there's an in-between. Do I think Zach LaVine's a good player? Absolutely. You don't average the points that he's doing on the efficiency that he's doing it on and have like all the advanced stats to say he's in the top 30 in the league offensively and self-creation and scoring. You can't be all that with and be a bad player. But I think his negatives, his passing and his defense, severely cripple your team right now from being a plus. You have to build a team around him that really covers his weaknesses bad if you want him to be a one. Now, he probably would be better at like a second or third option to where you just expect him to score and you're not asking him to do the playmaking and then you try to hide his defenses. But the Bulls are building as him to be the number one option on their team. And that's where it gets tricky because you can't have someone be your number one option on your team who really struggles at playmaking, really struggles at making his teammates better, really struggles with decision-making, and also be really bad on defense. So the Bulls have to make a decision here. Are they going to hope that Zach LaVine eventually develops as a playmaker? And kind of like DeMar DeRozan did. DeMar DeRozan is still pretty bad on defense, but he developed as a playmaker, so it kind of evened out a little bit to where you could have him on the floor and he could be a plus for you guys with his scoring and his playmaking, even though his defense wasn't that good. That's kind of what the Bulls need to hope for with Zach LaVine, that one of these things gets better. He gets better at playmaking and decision making, or he puts a little bit more effort in on defense. And I think that might be why they have Jim Boyle around to maybe try four some defense and try to get more out of him on that end. But really, until the Bulls get more out of Zach LaVine in one of those two aspects, it's really going to be tricky to build around him. And he's going to become one of the most controversial players in the game because the Bulls are probably going to continue to lose if he doesn't get better one of those things. And they're just going to start calling him a really bad player, which he's not. He's just a good player, a good offensive player with some serious flaws that can hurt your team. And yes, some of it can be put on how bad the Bulls are outside of Zach LaVine. I mean, Lauri Markkanen is taking a step back. Everyone hates Jim Boylan. And a lot of the players just simply are not that good. So yeah, some of it can be put on that, and Zach has to carry a lot of load on offense. I had a good friend of mine who follows Bradley Beal and the Washington Wizards tell me Bradley Beal was a good defender before this year, but he started to slack on defense and stop playing defense. Why? Because you have to carry so much in offense, it's hard to ask a player to go back down on defense and give it all they got when they know, one, they're going to lose anyways, and two, they're having to carry such a burden on offense. So maybe if the Bulls get a better team around Zach LaVine, maybe he gets a little bit better on defense. But honestly, in my opinion, I don't think he's ever going to become a good defender. I think he will probably become an average defender. If he becomes an average defender, that would be a real plus. I think the one real area that you can expect an improvement out of Zach LaVine legitimately is his playmaking and his decision making. If the Bulls can get that, he'll become a great player. But as of right now, he's a good player with some serious flaws that make him extremely controversial. And that's all I've got for you guys today. If you guys liked the video, make sure you guys give me a thumbs up down below. And like I mentioned earlier in the video, a lot of you guys that like my videos and watch my videos are not subscribe. So if you haven't already, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button because it really helped me out. Also, I have a second channel where I react to sports highlights, football and basketball. I have about, I think, 30 videos up right now. I'll put the link to that down below. So if you want to see some reactions to some of your favorite players, go ahead and comment down below what you guys would like to see in one of those videos over there. I'll put the link to my channel down below in the description. And don't forget to comment down below if there's a player you guys want me to dive into like I did with Zach LaVine and Colin Sexton. And until next time, I'll see you guys later. Peace out, y'all. Wow, did I really just do this whole video with a Bulls hat on and a Pistons shirt on?